Good evening.
Good evening.
Wow, that's great. Try that again. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Laura Kuhlman. I'm from a bit of ways away. I'm from Chicago. And about 3 years ago, I was at a music festival in Madison, Wisconsin. And I'm there to study some of these early instruments that we're going to introduce you to tonight. And there was a fellow player there with me, and she and I said, we need to start our own band. And so we kind of got together, and 6 degrees of separation, believe it or not, we found about 6 other people that actually knew how to play some of these instruments and had a love for this music that we will share with you tonight. Behind me are some very talented people that I'm happy to call my friends, and also music associates. Of course, I will forget their names, because I have to tell you what their names are. But to my right is Katie Poole, and she is from Kenosha, Wisconsin. Sitting by the candles, I'll see you in a second, is David Rasher. David Rasher hails from Milwaukee, one of the few people that actually live in Milwaukee, in the Milwaukee Renaissance Band. David Rasher. I should have said, Katie is our one of our brass specialists, and David shares the reed specialty with myself. And the next person I'm going to introduce to you is Ken Hamill, and he is from Madison, Wisconsin. Guesting with us tonight are two very, very talented musicians. Behind me, and we'll get out of the way so that you can see him in full, is Gary Birkenstock, who is... He used to be from Chicago, but he went and moved to Seattle, Washington. So he has come back. I know him from a double reed workshop, an early double reed workshop, and we are really happy to have him with us tonight. And then hailing from Madison, Wisconsin, is Anna Slate. And Anna. And Anna will be singing for us tonight. And with this music, we really believe that you can transport yourself back in time. A good friend of mine, when I was playing up in the Bristol Renaissance Fair, used to tell our audience that you can close your eyes tonight, sometime tonight, take a try at this, but close your eyes and you can transport yourself back in time, because surely before you tonight are the instruments that this music was written for, and the space that it was written for. It was played in churches, and if you do close your eyes, you can actually go back to the 15th and 16th century with us. The instruments that we're playing tonight are from the oboe, bassoon, and the brass family. The instruments that myself and Ken and David Rasher play are bassoons and oboes. They're called shawms and dulcians. David, if you can show us a shawm first. A shawm will become an oboe. You can almost see it right now, those of you that might know oboes. 6 finger holes and the open double reed. No double reeds actually exist anymore. None of them survived, but the instruments have survived, and thus the people that make these instruments for us were able to go into museums and study them and rebuild and recreate these instruments. Then we have the dulcians, and the dulcians came later. The dulcians are probably a late 16th century 16th century invention. They look like a bassoon, especially like the one Gary has. that will one day become a full-fledged bassoon. And all of these instruments were made in families because we mainly played vocal music. The instruments were made in what we call soprano, alto, tenor, and bass ranges. So we have little shawms, like my little shawm here. You want to lift that up? Ooh, can't go very far. So we have a small shawm all the way up to actually they made the bass shawm. But the bass shawm was so big and cumbersome that it actually went out of favor for the bass dulcian. Now, shawms and dulcians, quite big, quite interesting sound, as you will find out here in a few moments. And to soften the blow, so to speak, we brought in what we will call our brass family.
So the member of the brass family that I'll be playing tonight is the sackbut, and this will grow up one day to become the trombone. And actually, the design has not changed much. Slightly smaller bell than modern-day trombones. The bore size, or the width of the tubing, was much narrower back then. And we actually got to play with a flat mouthpiece instead of a rounded one. But this instrument has not changed much since the 15th, 16th century. It was very, very, a lot was written for it because it was softer and not so in your face and more of a vocal quality. We were used not only with the shawms and some of these brighter instruments, but we were able to play with vocalists and able to play with other ensembles because of the nature of this instrument. So this will grow up one day.
But everybody loves to say sackbut. It's just a fun word to say. It's more fun to say, I play the sackbut, than it is to say, I play the shawm. But no. So back in the day, every town, so Sturgeon Bay, I hear there's a place called Fish Creek and Egg Harbor. Everybody had a band. And these musicians were very important to each town because the music that they played was to tell the people in town about what they were doing all day. They would wake them up, they would put them to bed. They would tell them when it was time to go to church. Or they would play music for a funeral, music for a wedding, music for services. So these guys, they were pretty busy little people all day long. They were called the loud band, the alta cappella. Actually, when Milwaukee started, I was going to call the band the Milwaukee loud band. But then I thought, wow, people will probably think we're a rock and roll band. And then they would come, and then they would be sorely disappointed when we weren't playing heavy metal. So we went with the Milwaukee Renaissance Band. But they were called the Loud Band, not because they were loud, they were, but because of their heightness and pitch. Whereas you have the softer, or the bassa cappella, which were the recorders, and we're gonna play some of those tonight. Also, recorders were the little flutes. Yeah. There, she's grabbing one under the Christmas tree. Yes, but those will go home with us. Yeah, flutes, they're end-blown instruments. When you blow into the top of the instrument, there's a little block of wood, and it splits the air, and thus you get the sound. We're also going to play some really, really interesting instruments called crumb horns. And crumb horns look like the letter J. And they are called crumb horns not because their sound is crummy, but because the instrument is curved. And in German, the word for curved is krumm. And so it's called a crumb horn. And we believe it also has a double reed in it, but it's capped. And so when you blow in the instrument, the reed starts vibrating and makes this fabulous sound. And when you hear it, you're all going to want to go out and buy a crumb horn so that you can go on hunts or get in trouble with your neighbors. What else are we playing? We're playing bagpipes. Bagpipes tonight. Yeah, they're not the Highland bagpipes, but they're what we call Renaissance bagpipes because they have one drone and a chanter, and it's that bag thing still. Any other instrument I'm missing? Oh yes. We are playing the racket. Well, I'm not playing the racket. Gary's gonna play the racket. It's not a racket, like a racket of noise, but it's called a little Wurstfergott, or a sausage bassoon. It is actually actually inside longer than this instrument is. Then this instrument goes from here all the way down and comes back up. This instrument goes up and down about 16 times inside, and if it were to be drawn all the way up, is actually bigger than the bass dulcian, and it's also a quite amazing sound. So like I said, these guys were pretty busy. We believe that they were responsible for being able to play all these instruments, although there was specialization. Lead Shawn players like myself, that played the high voices, usually played high voices in all instruments they played. Whereas like Gary plays low instruments, and so all the instruments he plays are in the low range. The music that you're going to hear tonight was used to help teach the town folk about the birth of Jesus. During Mass, during dances, during parties, the word carol comes to us from a very, very ancient word in French. And it was actually for the word for dance. And it was supposed to be a lively tune. And it wasn't until later, into the 16th and 17th century, that the tune started becoming a little more somber, such as O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, or Coventry Carol. But very beautiful tunes in their own right. In the program you're going to see, there's little spaces between groups of pieces. Not that you have to keep track, because we want you to be enjoying what you're hearing, but that's in the spaces is where you can clap. So you'll think, okay, I can clap after A Solis, A Six. You'll know that it's A Six because we're all playing and singing. So after that, then you can clap. But we always say, as musicians, we live for the clap. The applause, that is. So we ask that you applaud whenever the moment appears. Whenever you feel like clapping, we love to hear applause. But we group them in little groups just to kind of keep the mood going, okay? So after it's all over, after this is all over, we invite you to come up and say hello to us. We want to meet you. We love playing. We love this music. And come see our instruments, because we can sit here and talk all night, but who wants to listen to me? We want to hear some music, right? So, Merry Christmas to all of you. Happy holidays. could do a whole concert on Solis Ortus. And we almost are. We're going to do four versions of Solis Ortus. It's a tune that comes to us from a very long time ago as a chant before they brought instruments into the church. And we're going to play the chant for you in a four-part setting. And then it was taken by other composers and developed into other tunes. And we're going to grow it from a four-part chant to a six-part beautiful piece.
Thank you.
we're going to take you back, really way back, and play some very early medieval music. One of the other instruments we didn't tell you about, and we'll do real quick, these are cornemuses, and they're a bit like the crumb horns. There's a double reed inside here, and when we blow it, it vibrates really big. One really interesting thing we can do with the cornemuse is that there's this little mute that could come out, and it can make it a little louder. So when we want to be soft, we mute. When we be loud, we unmute.
Thank you. season to tell the story of Jesus' birth. You're going to hear the bagpipes on the next one, introducing the three wise men with the tune Three Ships. These wise men came from foreign lands to pay homage to the birth of Jesus. We will then quiet down for the popular O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, or the Latin tune Veni, Veni, Emmanuel. And we're going to finish off the set with two lively tunes that continue the epic story of Jesus' birth.
O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, so please join in when I raise my arms.
Until the Son of God appear, preach Rio, Rio, Chiu, la Guadaribera, Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera. Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera.
Rio, Rio, Chiu, la Guadaribera,
Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera. Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera.
El lobo rabioso la quiso morder, mas Dios poderoso la supo defender. Quiso la hacer que no pudiese percar, ni aun original esta virgen no tuviera.
Río, río, chiu, la Guadaribera.
Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera. Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera. Este que es nacido es el gran monarca, Cristo patriarca de carne vestido, a nos redimido con se hace chiquito, que era infinito, finito se hiciera.
Río, río, chiu, la Guadaribera.
Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera. Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera.
Por aquí volando, haciendo mil sones, diciendo vascastones, gloria sea en el cielo, y paz en el suelo, pues Jesús naciera.
Río, río, chiu, la Guadaribera,
Dios guardó el
lobo de nuestra codera.
Dios guardó el lobo
de nuestra codera.
Y viene a reparar de todos la caída. Es la luz del día que estemos suelo. Este es el cordero que San Juan dixera.
Río, río, chiu, la Guadaribera.
Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera.
Dios guardó el lobo de nuestra codera.
Padre que ansina lo hiera, que Dios no pudiera hacerla más madre, el que era su padre hoy de la nació, y el que la crió su hijo se dijera.
Río, río, chiu, la Guadaribera,
Dios guardó
el lobo de nuestra codera.
Dios guardó
el lobo de nuestra codera.
Pues que ya tenemos lo que deseamos, todos juntos vamos, presentes llevemos, todos le daremos nuestra voluntad, pues así igualla con el hombre viniera.
¶¶ Journey of Mary and Joseph to Bethlehem and the birth of Jesus. This too, Salite Unigenito, raise your voices to the Lord in praise.
Concert have arrangements of the next tune that you're going to hear. O Magnum Mysterium is a chant from the 16th century, and it's been set over and over and over and over again by some of the greatest composers of the Renaissance, which you'll hear a version of that next. Our final tune in this half, Resonat Laudibus, calls to let the voice of praise resound and sing praises that on Christmas Day we celebrate the birth of Jesus. This tune you will hear at the end has been popularized to the tune, Joseph Dearest, Joseph Mine.
Thank you.
next song will be Joseph Dearest, Joseph Mine. And if you know this one, please, again, sing along.
We'll take a short intermission, give you time to stretch your legs. But please, do join with us as we sing Joseph Lever, Joseph Mine.
So this is a little smaller reed, so it's harder. It's much more taxing. So it's the same with the bagpipe. That's a real taxing instrument. You think it's... No,
it looked like taxing as you were playing. That's why I asked the question.
Oh, yeah. Really?
It could get a little...
Yes. Actually, I have a friend in Ecuador right now, and we were down there performing last March.
Where does the sound come out then? Little holes. It's amazing you can get much sound out of that little hole.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, okay.
And it's played dry.
Yeah, it has a rhythm. So that must be kind of tricky.
It's kind of like a kazoo, basically.
Oh.
Yeah, so you don't get it wet.
This is the sackbut, which predecessor to the trombone.
The fingering is
brassy sound.
Thank you.
Continue on at kind of in a Spanish mode with Los Reyes. next piece that we're going to do is Coventry Carol, and it's a really kind of a heartbreaking tune. It's a lullaby that a mother sings to her baby son, who is probably going to be killed when Herod killed all the little babies. But it's actually a absolutely beautiful tune, and I hope you enjoy our rendition of it.
Tiny child.
probably one of my absolute fabulous, most favorites, composers of the Renaissance has to be Anthony Holborn, a German composer, and he did, there must be a book of about 90 dances that he wrote for a consort of instruments. We're going to do what we call a broken consort. A full consort would be all like instruments. So when we played all the dulcians, that's a consort. A broken consort is what you see up here, is where we're playing recorders and sackbuts and dulcians. And we're going to do a set of dances that will get your feet a-tapping.
Thank you.
very, very much. We'd like to thank Door Concerts for having us up here. We'd love to come back and see you guys again. And we're going to finish out our concert with a tune by His Royal Highness Henry VIII. Now, not quite sure he actually wrote it, but when you're king, you can say anything, right? No, he was actually a very, very good musician. He employed a lot of musicians in his household, and we know that at the time of his reign, he actually had like 76 recorders and an orchestra full of string instruments. So he really, really loved music. And this is one of these tunes where we, we're spending time with good friends and family during this Christmas season. And at the end, join back in with us as we sing Pastime with Good Company.
Pastime with good company, I love and shall until I die. Grudge who lust, but none deny. So God be pleased, thus live will I. For my pastimes, hunt, sing, and dance, my heart is set. All goodly sport for my comfort, who shall me let?
Youth
have to go home and say, I sang with the Renaissance Wind Band. And if you want to sing along with this, all you need to know are three simple syllables, I think, right? Ale salite. Ale, what is it?
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Oh, yeah, that's right. That's why I play the shawm and she sings. So sing it for us, Ken, and then you can sing along with us.
Ale.